Alright guys, so big news coming in for Ontario PNP aspirants. Finally, the new EOI system has been launched for the Ontario province's PNP system. We are discussing the new EOI system in this video today. Please be tuned till the end. My name is Sahil. Alright guys, so welcome back once again. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant and I practice in Brampton, Ontario. But right now I'm traveling to India, so if you have to get in touch with me, please make a note of my Canadian number for a quick WhatsApp conversation and my Indian number while I'm traveling to India for a quick general call for your discussion. Guys, if you are watching this video for the first time, if you are on this channel for the first time, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button and the bell icon, because we talk a lot about Canadian immigration, and if you are an aspirant, then this is the channel that you must watch all the time. Guys, what we are discussing today is an important aspect of Canadian immigration, which is called PNP. Now, we all know when it comes to PNP or even if it comes to PR at large, most of the people who are looking forward to coming to Canada usually look at Ontario and the city Toronto when it comes to their preference of moving. So it's either Toronto, Ontario, or usually Vancouver, British Columbia. And that is the reason why Ontario PNP happens to be one of the most public popular choices all the time. And thus April 28, 2021 brought in a very good news from the province by itself. And the news was basically that the EOI system under the Ontario PNP is finally live, it's launched, and people can now start taking the benefits out of this new launch system. But I know a lot of people might have a lot of questions that Sahil, what is, some people might not even know what is Ontario PNP, some people might not even know what is EOI, and a lot of people don't really even know how does the PNP work. So in this particular video, we are going to be discussing all these details, so make sure that you watch until the end. So first things first, to be very clear, Ontario launched under its PNP program the EOI system. Now, Ontario PNP, just discussing at large, so basically guys, PNP is a provincial nomination program where a province gets a sort of a quota allocation from the federal government, and the province can invite candidates for permanent residence under its own PNP, the provincial nomination program, in order to meet the labor market needs. Okay, so in a nutshell, if a province requires a lot of IT professionals, then it might pick up all the interested applicants or some of the interested applicants, give them an NOI, which is called a notification of interest, which the applicant, once receives the NOI, can use that particular NOI to either claim 600 points on express entry or apply for directly PR based on what the kind of NOI it is, alright, or what the kind of a program it is. But yes, based on the NOI, you can directly apply for a PR afterwards. So, but first, the PNP NOI is the first step, usually if you are selecting PNP route. Okay, so this is what the PNP actually means. Now, when we talk about Ontario, like I said, it is by far one of the most famous provinces, and a lot of people want to come over to Canada and reside in Ontario, and that's by far the largest population of Canada is in this particular province. So until now, Canada had been receiving a lot of PNP requests or had been inviting candidates either directly through the express entry pool, which was a very small chunk, but a lot of people had the option of applying directly to Ontario. And that was all happening until now based on a first come first serve basis. So what really happened was, if you were an international graduate student or a master's graduate or anybody who's eligible under Ontario would wait for that one fine day in a particular year when Ontario would open the PNP, sit in front of your laptops and computers on that particular morning at around 8:15 or 9 a.m. and then as soon as the Ontario PNP would open, people would start clicking. And then it was mostly like, the lucky finger first or the fastest finger first, wherein if you were able to log in your profile, then you would move ahead to submit your PNP, right? So a lot of people got the PNPs, really found that helpful, because at that moment it was all about getting your eligibility. And even if you got an eligibility just by being by getting a normal diploma, you would be able to get your PR. And then a lot of people thought that it was not really fair, because a lot of more deserving candidates were there who had better qualifications, better education and experience, thought they were all left out. And also See, the Ontario PNP, because it was a first come first serve basis, so a lot of applicants were there and the annual quota was very small when compared to the number of interested applicants. So that's the reason why Ontario decided to change. And the another reason was also because Ontario wanted to match its labor market priorities much more better, you know, to the interested applicants. So they would have, you know, a plethora of applicants wherein they would want to pick and choose the applicants from. So all of this put together made real sense for Ontario to launch the EOI system. Now I'm going to explain what exactly the EOI system is. Now guys, EOI system basically means expression of interest. Okay, it is similar to what the express entry is. So what really happens is when the EOI system opens on the, you know, the login profiling platform of Ontario, so you or an applicant would be able to make or submit the expression of interest in that particular system. And what will happen is, based on your particular profile, you would be allocated certain points. So let's say points based on your skills, your job type, your wages, the length of employment, and then your earning history, level of education, and there are a lot of categories. Okay, so you will be given certain points based on your profile, and then you will be placed in the pool of candidates for OINP, which is Ontario PNP, for a period of 12 months. Okay, and then the province of Ontario will be inviting people from that pool based on, you know, draws every now and then. So that is how the things will work. Once invited to apply for PNP, the person will be submitting the profile to Ontario, and once the person receives an NOI, receives an invitation, then the person will be moving towards the PR application. But just putting in your name in the PNP does not mean that you will receive a PNP for sure. Okay, also applying to the PNP has no charges whatsoever, it's free, but you will be bearing the charges once the province invites you to apply for PNP. Okay, so this is how a PNP works. Now let's come to Ontario PNP EOI system. Now guys, Ontario has a lot of PNP streams under its PNP, right? So streams like foreign worker, international students, master's graduate, PhD graduate, you have in-demand skills, you know, human capital priorities, all of these and many others, right? So all of these are there. Some of them are still under the first come first serve, and some of them have been migrated to this new EOI system. Okay, now for now, on April 28th 2021, Ontario moved the two streams, which was the foreign worker and the international student stream, to the EOI system. So if you go onto the Ontario PNP page today, you will be able to create your profile, submit an EOI, and then wait for Ontario to hold a draw and send you an invitation if you clear the cutoff, okay, or if you meet the requirements of that particular draw. What is going to be the draw like, how much is going to be the cutoff, or if there are going to be other requirements, let's say in English, or maybe other added on requirements, that the province will tell in each and every draw. We are yet to see the first draw. We are not sure if they're only going to keep it point based or they're going to keep some matching requirements, that we will come to know in the coming few days. But for now, I think all the information that you needed is given by me already in this video. It's a very interesting province, and it's a very interesting program, and it's a much awaited PNP change that was required, because a lot of people had been, you know, used to keep waiting whenever the Ontario PNP would launch, and then, you know, it was a very tiring and a very nail biting moment for everybody that morning when any PNP stream would open under Ontario, and then people would be literally, you know, on their systems and laptops since, you know, the previous night preparing files, you don't know, and, you know, students would be worried, people would be worried, and, you know, everybody was, you know, in a nail biting stage. But I think the EOI system really takes care of everything. Also, it gives the PNP to much more deserving candidates. I know a lot of people might not be happy with this EOI system because they will not be able to clear the cutoff, or they would not be able to meet the requirements. But guys, look at the larger benefit from the eyes of the province. One, they get to, you know, choose the candidates much more, in a much more organized manner when it comes to their labor market priorities. Also, a lot of deserving candidates are there, which by fair means are there. I know a lot of people spend a lot of money in terms of gathering eligibility, but I think when it comes to the selection, that is how Express Entry also works, that is how Canada works, and that is how Ontario is now also going to function. So it is pretty much in line with the way entire immigration has been functioning, which is giving immigration to the much more deserving candidates and the eligible candidates rather than just a lucky based system. But yes, it is what it is. I personally think it's a good one, saves a lot of time, has much more organized manner of application, will be fairer, and the people who are not able to meet the requirements, don't be disheartened, because Canada has a lot of other immigration programs, pilot programs and everything. You will find something or the other if you are able to meet the eligibility criteria. Guys, I hope the information was helpful, pretty much gave you all the insights that you wanted to. More than this, if you want to discuss your particular profile for Ontario PNP, I would be more than happy to do so. Kindly feel free to book a consultation using the number on the screen through WhatsApp, which is the Canadian number, or I am also available on a regular phone call while I am traveling to India on the Indian number. Once again, it was lovely chatting with you, and I really hope that you guys get your deserved PRs and visas, and I hope to see you soon in Canada. All the best.